You always enjoyed surprising him whenever you could. While he's at work, probably saving lives, or keeping a certain blonde from lashing onto someone, you sat at home, doing your best to prepare everything for your little surprise to be perfect. Sensual music could be heard from outside the apartment, making his heart beat rapidly as his hand shook in anticipation as he tried to open the door. Being met with dim light, candles all over the place giving out some nice smell. Vanilla? Rose? He had no idea. He didn't care. Not when his wonderful partner is standing in the middle of the living room, smirk decorating their face and waiting for Kirishima to join them. As your hips sway to the music, lips moving, not missing any single lyrics, as you slowly approach him. Your hands running up and down his sweaty arms, sending shiver down his spine, before taking his large callous hands in yours and giving them to the couch, making him sit down and telling him how to carefully watch. Your body never missing a bit, as your fingers travel up your body, from tight, ass, chest, face, and settling into your hair. Your eyes closing for merely a second, letting yourself get lost in the melody. But as soon as you did that, you felt an unwelcome presence behind you. Eyes snapping, an icy look glazing them as you stare into his red ones, ordering him to get back to his place. And who was he to disobey you? After this not so pleasant interruption, you went back to dancing, not forgetting to bend down slightly, shaking your eyes in front of his face. Your own fingers tracing every curve and dip of your body. You couldn't help the wave of pride washing over you as you saw his orbs observing your every move, following you everywhere. You can feel him just wanting to bounce up, tear away that oversized you're wearing. Feeling generous and nice, you did it for him. Taking it off slowly and teasingly before throwing it somewhere on the ground to be taken care of later. With nothing but those cute red underwear on, Kirishima was getting closer and closer to his limit, still not much energy flowing through his body. Pent up anger and frustration, he just wanted to bend you over right now and fuck you till you passed out. But you, on the other hand, you wanted to take things slow, or at least see how long your pretty boyfriend can last before bursting. Dropping to your knees and crawling towards him, fakiness and so evident in your eyes as you sing the word with so much sinful purity dripping from your voice. He was having none of your attitude, and if it was any other time, he would have put you back to your place, reminding you that you're nothing for a slut. A slut for him. But he let it go, waiting for your next movement. Your hands, resting on his knees, sometimes caressing up his thigh, but never higher than that. Your lips parting slightly, her lashes fluttering, he knew what you wanted. Chocolate escaping his throat as his tongue traveled down your cheeks and into your mouth, lips quickly wrapping around the digit, sucking on it and cheeks hollow as you did so. Tongue swirling around and feet barely beating down to tease him just a little. It was when you pull away with a pop, turning around and bending over the table before him, finger putting your string down your legs, a strip of arousal attaching the material to your sex, glistering under the light, even more when you couldn't help your hips from rolling to the beats. It was then that he lost it. Abruptly standing up, turning the music off and yanking you up as he stared coldly into your eyes. "That was cute, baby, but now, let's the real fun begin, yeah?"